What's up, YouTubers and socials? It is day two, and I am showing up for you vlogging. It's Vlogging Brandy here, and I put out a question on Instagram the other day and said, if you could have a cup of coffee with me, what would you want to ask me about business, life, mindset? I want to know. And I received several questions about this topic, and I really want to dive into this today. How do you fight the feeling that you're not good enough to do this or that? And how do you create an environment for yourself where only positive vibes exist, not negative ones? So thank you, Days of Your Mom and Mohan, for submitting those questions to me. I appreciate it, and I wanted to answer this for you. So just this week, I had a very similar situation kind of happen where people upset me and it kind of threw me off my vibe. And what's worse is when it's someone that you really care about or look up to. It could be your boss, a parent, or a best friend. It just really depends on who you look up to, but the problem that I find people doing is you put a lot of your emotions into other people. So it's like you put your success on them, on how they're feeling, to make you feel a certain way. And certain people can do that to us. So for me, mine was really stupid that somebody even commented on. I was sleeping and I got yelled at for leaving the TV and the lights on. I mean, I got like super yelled at. It was pretty much like, you suck for leaving the lights on, and I'm kicking you out or something like that. So for me, I just take that with a grain of salt and I'm like, okay, well, first off, let's consider the source. Second off, who are you talking to? Because I know you're not talking to me. And third, let's think about what this person might be going through. And do they really mean those things? Or is it just in the heat of the moment? Because some people are really grumpy at night versus grumpy in the morning. Those are things that you have to think about. Put yourself in someone else's shoes. So when they made that comment to me, it just really upset me because first off, I really wasn't doing anything wrong. And who gives a about the lights or the TV. My gosh, they really don't take up that much. And let's be real, y'all. If you want to talk about power bills, it all has to do with your AC and what you're doing with your washer, dryer, things like that. Those take up a lot more power. Leaving lights on is not that big of a deal. But either way, it really upset me and it made me not be able to focus on the other things that I was doing. It was so simple, but I also know that this person has their own issues. They're like a control freak. They literally have to have everything put in a place or they go crazy. They're OCD, and it had nothing to do with me. So at first I let it upset me, but the more, you know, I kind of talked it through because I like talk to myself. So I walked around like, you know what, screw you. How dare you say that to me? Like I literally talked to myself for several days and it just finally came to the point. And when I saw these questions, I was like, okay, well, I go through this same thing. We all do. But I also made sure that I just put my videos out there whenever I was like happy and nobody else would know what I was going through. What I want you to think of when you're putting yourself in these positions about whether it's a positive or negative situation, and don't think about what the other person is doing or saying. Just think about yourself and put yourself into a place of happiness and peace because you are the keeper of your own peace. So turn your pain into power if you want to really break through the noise of what's holding you back. You cannot control what other people are going to say and do to you. You can only control yourself and how you respond in that situation. You never know what that person's going through, what just happened to them. So keep that in mind whenever they come at you in some kind of way that you're not okay with. And don't take it personal. Just remember, if you're in the checkout line and that girl gives you an attitude or doesn't say hey, one, she just might not understand how to give good customer service because no one ever trained her. It could be her first day on the job. Her dog could have just died. Her boss could have just yelled at her. Her boyfriend could have just broke up with her. You never know what other people are going through. And keep in mind, text messages, phone calls, all these different mediums that we have, and we're talking to people on, those are bound to have a different connotation when they come across the other side. If someone's emailing me and I get an email from them and they say something to me versus if I talk to them on the phone, I know that it's going to sound completely different. Most people that meet me in person versus talk to me on the phone or in text or here on YouTube see a completely different person sometimes because I'm very quiet and shy and I don't really talk that much when you get to know me. I talk more online and I'm just more social. I actually get really overwhelmed when I meet people in person. I love to talk to large groups, but if I'm stuck and I'm just talking like one-on-one to people for a long period of time, I get really overwhelmed. Just like going to big events or things like that kind of get me really flustered and I'll start getting snappy, you know? If I'm hungry, different things can set me off. So you have to find your medium and what works for you and start improving on those things. And keep in mind that it's not always them. It can also be you. What are you going through? Did somebody just yell at you? Are you thinking that they're mad at you, but really you're mad at yourself or you're upset about something else? Do you ever see yourself snap on other people because of something you're going through? Well, what about those situations? How do you think they feel? That might not be a positive environment for them. It's a negative environment that you are admitting. And we all know when someone talks to you negative, the first thing that you want to do is snap back at them. But that just gives them more power and it just makes them feel better. So it's ultimately the worst response. Say it again. You are the keeper of your own peace. At the end of the day, no one can ruffle your feathers unless you allow them to. People do what they do because that is where they are in their life, in their job, in their relationship. Whatever it is that they're emitting off to you, that negative energy or that positive energy, that's where they are. If someone just got a new job or just got a new car, they're usually like really excited and they're like, hey, come ride in my car. Hey, I just got this new job. I want to tell you about it. But then that day, whenever their boss yells at them, they might snap on you and you might not know. They probably aren't going to be like, well, my boss just pissed me off and then this car just pissed me off in traffic and you suck. They're not going to say that. They're just going to be like, you suck. And you're going to be like, okay, what did I do? What just happened? So you have to be able to remember that people do what they do because that is where they are in that situation, in that moment, in that place, in their life. And you are in that same position. You can choose to do what you want to do in that moment, how you're going to react, how you're going to respond, or not respond. And when that person ruffles your feathers, do you really think that they're over there crying and upset? No, they're probably doing whatever they want and just you're over there upset, crying, pissed off, happy, whatever it is, but that other person is just going on about their day like they never even probably knew what they did to you. And a lot of times you may not ever get that satisfaction of having an apology, although it would be nice. Don't expect it. That's why you're in this world for yourself, and at the end of the day, when it all passes away, there's only one person left standing. Something can happen to your friends, your family, your boss, your coworkers tomorrow. We're not promised tomorrow. So stop thinking about all of these people. You do not have to be friends with other people. You don't have to be friends with everyone. You don't have to hang out with all of your coworkers. You don't have to have that job. You know, I quit my job because of the toxic environment I was in and I didn't want to be a part of it, even though I made shit tons of money. I didn't care. My happiness was more important. So at the end of the day, it's up to you whether you choose to stay in those situations with those people. It doesn't have to be that day and that time and outweigh the pros and the cons. Just because somebody's upset one day, are they happy all the other days and it's just that one day that they rubbed you wrong? Or is it you that's upset that day and maybe they didn't rub you wrong? It's just something that they said you took a little bit more personally. So we're on day two of vlogging with Brandy. I am super excited, so keep the questions coming. I want to hear, what are your comments? What are people saying to you? What is something mean that someone said to you, or positive that someone said to you? Put that in the comments. Or if it's something that you really need help breaking through, then connect with me. I'm putting everything down in the description so you can work with me. You can get my free resources. Reach out to me. We can kind of talk and work through, get you a plan going. I have clients that I work with on a day-to-day basis, so I'd love to help you break through the noise. In the meantime, make sure that you subscribe to my channel. Thanks for watching. I'm Brandy of vlogandbrandy.com, where you can find tons of free resources to help you brand your business. And I will see you in the next video tomorrow. And I can't sing, so don't expect me to be singing, but I'm here for your joy and entertainment. So have a wonderful day, YouTubers. I love you and I want to see you succeed. So we're here to do this together, and I am going to be showing up. So where are you? Let me see you in the comments. Subscribe and let's get this party started.